a guy who backs his instinct, and the captain backs his instinct of putting Kedar Jadhav in with his bowling, with his batting. As soon as you put him under the pump in any situation, he becomes a fountain, right? From hand pump to fountain. And this is, now see his numbers of what he's done. He's been consistently for the last couple of years coming into bat in difficult positions, seeing the team through. This is a montage of all his stuff. I'm not going to read all of it, but just to basically remind you, the macro thought that runs through all of it, it's a 70 for 4, 80 for 4, Kedar Jadhav comes in chasing 250 plus. More often than not, almost 80% of the time, he sees it through. And does he not get enough credit for his batting, is my question to you gentlemen.
If you put that question to me, I didn't have him in my side. So yes, yeah. I guess he's not.
You did put him after the last game.
Yes, I guess I'm not giving him enough credit. But just an observation.
I think we all are.
So one of the observations that I have there is, you know, whether he comes on to bowl, it's always, you never get him on to bowl as a first spinner.
Yeah.
Or when things are going well. If you've gone through your bowlers and nothing's worked, and the opposition is in a commanding position, that's when you bring him in.
So 24 of his 26 wickets, by the way, yeah, in the last year, 2 years that he's taken.
That's how he became
a bowler. Top order.
Yeah. So from a batsman point of view, I'd make a point is that when I'm scoring at 5-6 and over, I've got through the bowlers, then the bowlers that you get out to are different. Whereas if you're 4 down and, you know, your teams or the opposition's on top of you, you'd actually prefer to have Kedar bowl to you and not Kuldeep or Ravindra.
So that's the reason why he's got top 7 wickets, is because he comes in as a partnership breaker, yeah, when you're stuck.
Yeah.
And that's so, when you bowl Kedar Jadhav, so golden arm, which is why they're calling him. Yeah.
So on that front, it's the weakness that I'm looking at. But on the batting side, if you look at the numbers, he's always done it when you're in trouble.
Yeah.
And that is what is going to happen. If you bat at 6, you'll, you know, rarely come into bat when you're not in trouble, or when, yeah, you have enough time. No, or you'll come in with 5 overs to go, then it really, yeah, doesn't matter. So his batting is what really has made the big contribution. But bowling is probably the more point of talking, or, you know, something that's unusual. Everybody enjoys it. It's a conversational point. And so his bowling is not as good as how
the
much numbers suggest, but his batting is probably better than what his numbers are suggesting.
So
I apologize for not taking
So we can say his bowling may be not good, as good as the numbers suggest, but it is effective. The situation that he plays in, he gets the job done. May not be getting it done in the rule book, classical sort of beautiful off spinner kind
it
of way.
See, we were talking about Finch right now, what he's going through in his mind.
Yeah.
Here's another example. You know, he's on the other side. His bowling has improved, not just the bowling, you know, not by technique or anything. It's just the fact that he has got the confidence now of bowling those 5 overs, 6 overs. And how that has happened? That has happened because he's been consistently taking the wickets. So that's something, you know, he started his career as a bowler who would come in as a last resort for the captain,
where
nothing has worked.
It was MS and now, who started bringing him in, right? Because before he started bowling for India, just adding to what you're saying, before he started bowling for India, he had bowled in first class cricket a grand total of 12, not times, 12 overs.
So someone discovered his ability with the ball.
Yeah.
And now he's just growing in confidence. So, you know, in terms of when you look at him technically, or you say that, okay, a lot of batsmen who has played him, you know, a little bit in the first class, or has been scoring runs consistently at the first class level, they will be looking at Kedar Jadhav and thinking that, oh, I wish I
laddu de do.
They'll be thinking international cricket mein aise bhi bowling aati hai. You know, they will be thinking like that. But he's effective. And he's growing in confidence with the fact that he's figured out a way. If you look at international cricket, you know, you don't get this kind of bowling to face.
Yeah.
You don't get this kind of pace also. So that is what is working for him. And the surprising fact is none of the international batsmen have been figured out a way of how they can tackle Kedar Jadhav.
I'll tell you exactly.
I think the pressure at the international level plays a huge role.
Yeah.
And that's what. That's what Kedar Jadhav has been very smart in understanding. You know, he understands that how the psyche of batsmen works in certain scenarios, and he uses that to his advantage.
The only way international batsmen can play Kedar Jadhav, especially when he bowls that ball from 4.5 feet, you can never practice in the nets. The only way you can do it is if you have a child who's 10 years old or 11 years old, get that child to bowl to you, because only then will you be able to match that height.
Absolutely.
10 and 11 is also too much. Probably 7 or 8 years old, right? 4.5 foot se jo ball aati hai yahan se.